亲爱的弟兄姊妹，祝你平安。
Sisters and brothers, Lord, peace with you.
很感谢主，我们能够在这里跟大家见面。
I'm so thankful that I can be here and share with you guys.
在耶稣基督里面，我们都是一家人。
We are one family in Jesus Christ.
Amen. 这次是一个特别的一个机会，我能够来到美国。
I got a special chance to come here, in the United States this time.
是参加我女儿的毕业典礼。
And I'm coming to join my daughter's commencement.
这次我们全家都来到这里，还有我的妻子，还有两个女儿。
This time, my family come with me, my wife and my two daughters.
我们今天一起来的还有叶老师，还有他的先生。
We come here together with also Pastor Lee and her husband, Frank.
今天我们大家一同聚在一起，我们来敬拜我们的神。
Today is a worship time that we can gather together here.
当我们在敬拜的时候，虽然我听不到大家唱的这个歌词。
When we worship together, although I cannot understand what you guys are singing.
但是在灵里面能够感受到我们都在敬拜我们的神。
But in spirit, I feel that we are all worshiping God.
我们非常的感恩。
I'm so thankful.
这次能够有这样的机会，在这跟大家能够来分享神的话语。
I'm so thankful that I can have this chance to be here to share God's words.
借这样的机会能够来见证神奇妙的作为。
And I can use this chance to tell God's great works in China.
我想跟大家来分享神在中国他自己的作为。
I really want to talk about the work of God in China.
在这我要跟大家能够来分享生命在逼迫中成长。
Today I'm going to share my message is about the life grows in persecution.
教会在逼迫中复兴。
And the church will revival in persecution.
其实谈到逼迫在中国的教会，我也觉得这是很平常的事。
When we talk about persecution, it is very normal in Chinese churches in China.
中国作为一个无神论的国家。
In China, we are a country that with no God.
但是在这个国家，处处都彰显神的作为。
But in this country, there are a lot of God's great works here.
常常经历神的同在。
And you guys always experience the presence of God.
神迹奇事不断的发生。
There are a lot of miracles.
看到神在中国无处不在。
And God is everywhere in China.
我们将荣耀归给我们的神。
Let's praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
我们来看出圣经是罗马书的第八章三十五节到三十九节。
Let's look at a scripture in Romans chapter 8, 35-39.
谁能使我们与基督的爱隔绝呢？难道是患难吗？是困苦吗？是逼迫吗？是饥饿吗？是赤身肉体吗？是危险吗？是刀剑吗？如经上所记，我们为你的缘故，终日被杀，人看我们如将宰的羊。然而靠着爱我们的主，在这一切的事上已经得胜有余了。因为我深信，无论是死是生，是天使是掌权的，是有能的，是现在的事，是将来的事，是高处的，是低处的，是别的受造之物，都不能叫我们与基督与神的爱隔绝。这爱是在我们的主基督耶稣里的。阿们。
Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquers through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
接着说圣经是在马太福音的第5章10到12节。
Let's look at the second scripture in Matthew chapter 5, verses 10 to 12.
为受逼迫的人有福了，因为天国是他们的。人若因我辱骂你们、逼迫你们、捏造各样坏话毁谤你们，你们就有福了，应当欢喜快乐，因为你们在天上的赏赐是大的。
Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you.
中国的教会 经历了极大的逼迫。
The churches in China experience a lot of persecution.
有逼迫就有复兴。
But when there is persecution, there is revival.
有复兴就会有逼迫。
And when there is revival, there is also persecution.
从复兴到宣教，从逼迫到复兴， 这是神在中国教会他奇妙的作为。
God's will for Chinese churches is from persecution to revival, and from revival to be missionaries.
在中国这样的一个国家，
In China,
它是一个抵挡神的一个国家。
We always defend God.
不接受福音。
We reject the gospel.
但是神所奇妙的在中国孕育了很大的一批神的仆人和侍女。
But God has prepared a lot of his servants in China.
在中国这片土地上,
in the land of China,
有很多为着神完全摆上的人。
There are a lot of people, they prepared themselves for God.
在中国他们为主做了很美好的见证。
They have a lot of great testimonies for God.
我今天想借着神在我们这个家庭当中的见证，
Today, I'm going to share some testimonies about my family. And we are the witness of God's great work in our family and our church. There are a lot of churches experience the same great thing in China.
因着福音为主受了很多的逼迫。
They experience a lot of persecution because of gospel.
但是他们从来没有放弃。
But they never gave up.
为主做了美好的见证。
And they are great witness of Jesus Christ.
我们这个家庭已经有100多年的信仰的历史。
Our family has more than 100 years of being Christians.
我是从小生长在一个基督化的家庭。
I was born in a Christian family.
我是第四代的基督徒。I
am the fourth generation Christian.
我的女儿算第五代。And
my daughter is the fifth Christian generation.
从我的曾祖父开始接受福音。The
first generation is my great grandfather, great great grandfather.
一直到今天。
Till now,
在我们这个家庭当中,
in our family,
神他奇妙的手一再引导我们。
God's great hand always lead us.
因为当我的曾祖父信耶稣的时候,
when my great grandfather got to know gospel,
那个时候信耶稣的人很少。
At that time, there were not a lot of Christians in China.
那个时候称 信耶稣的人称基督徒是称洋教。
They call Christianity is a Western religion.
因为福音是从西方传过去的。
Because the gospel was spread from the Western countries.
那时候中国人都不喜欢。
At that time, a lot, most of the Chinese people don't like this region.
但我们这个家庭接受了福音以后。
When our family began to receive this gospel,
特别感受到神很大的恩典。
We experienced the great presence of Lord.
这由我的曾祖父带领我们全家都相信耶稣。
My great grandfather lead all our families to Jesus Christ.
并且传福音。
And then we share the gospel.
要带领很多人相信。
And bring more people to Jesus Christ.
但当他接受福音之后
，And when he received the gospel，
在那个时代，他经历很大的逼迫。
At that time, he experienced a lot of persecution。
在那时候，有一个义和团的运动。
At that time, there was a boxer movement in China。
那时候专门屠杀国外的宣教士。
This movement always kill missionaries from the Western countries。
也杀害中国的基督徒。
And they also kill the Chinese Christians。
但神当时特别保守。
At that time, God really protected us.
当他们这些义和团的人要到我们家里去的时候
，When the people who belong to the boxer movement, before they came to our home,
他们每一次在杀人之前
every time before they kill someone,
他们首先要到那个村里的那个庙去拜。
They first went to the temple and worship.
他们拜完了以后，然后他们去杀人。
After they worship, they go and kill the Christians.
我相信他们也是借这个邪灵的力量。
I think at that time they use they were influenced by Satan.
当他们要到我家里去的时候
，Before they came to our house,
就有人事先告诉我的曾祖父。
Someone told my grandparents before they came.
他说义和团的人已经要来了。
He said that the people who from boxer movement they are going to come.
他说你们赶紧想办法先躲一躲。
So you guys should find a place to hide and to hide for this.
当时我的曾祖父就带领我们的家人离开了我们的家。
And then my great-grandfather took all our families to live for another place.
到了我们的亲戚家里去。
And to our other family's house.
义和团的人到我们家看没有人。
When the people from boxing movement, when they came, there was no person there.
然后就把我们家里所有的东西抢掠一空。
And they took all our properties of our house, and our house was empty.
虽然失去这一切的家业。
Although we lose all our properties,
但神保守了我们全家人的性命。
But God protects our lives.
那是神特别的恩典。
That is God's great grace.
因为我们深深知道。
Because we know that.
没有耶和华是我们的产业。
Only God is our property.
他是我们杯中的份。
And God is the property of our cup.
地上这一切虽然失去。
Although we lose everything on earth.
但是我们却得到最宝贵的。
But we earn the most precious thing.
就是我们的信仰。
It's our belief, our Jesus.
Amen. Amen. 当我的爷爷那个时代。
During my grandpa's time.
教会又遭受很大的逼迫。
There was also a great persecution among Chinese churches.
因为在那个时候，教会已经非常的复兴。
At that time, there was a great revival among the churches.
在我们村里已经有很多的信徒。
In our village, there are so many Christians.
神也启示我的爷爷，让他盖了一个礼拜堂。
And God has God told my grandpa to build a house for him.
当时也能够容纳几百人。
And to build a church for him, which can include a lot of people.
但是在文化大革命那个时候
，But that time was during the Chinese revolution.
当这运动开始的时候
，The revolution movement of China, at the beginning of this movement,
他们就有人来找我的爷爷商量。
There are some people came to my grandpa and said to him.
告诉我的爷爷说不要信这个耶稣了。
And they told my grandpa that do not believe in Jesus Christ anymore.
但只要你说不相信。
If you don't see, if you see that, you won't be a Christian anymore.
我们就跟上面汇报。
We will tell our the leaders of our government.
你们这个家庭就没有什么困难了。
That there will be no persecution, no difficulties in your family.
但是我爷爷当时他是一个医生。
And at that time, my grandfather was a doctor.
他自己也办了医院。
And he has his own hospital.
但是在我们本地啊，非常有好的名声。
And he has really a good name among our local area.
这些外邦人不愿意啊，这样的灾难临到我们这个家庭。
And so the non-believers of our local area, they do not want this kind of persecution to our family.
所以他们一直就去劝我的爷爷。
So they always keep saying to my grandpa.
你不要信这个耶稣了。
That you shouldn't believe in Jesus Christ anymore.
你只要不信耶稣。
Unless you don't believe.
因为这个家庭会很好的。
Your family will be very great.
你只要相信耶稣。
But if you do believe,
现在你们这个家庭要遭受灾难了。
There will be disaster in your family.
但是我的爷爷跟他们讲。
And that time, my grandpa told them that.
头可断，血可流。
My head can be cut and my blood can be flowed.
耶稣不能不信。
But I cannot repudiate the name of Jesus Christ.
他这是我唯一的信仰。
And this is my only belief.
所以从那个时候，我的爷爷就被抓去批斗。
At that time, my grandpa was taken to the government.
他们把他的医院全部没收。
They closed all his hospitals.
他们把他带到那个审判的那个地方。
They took them to a place in public.
把他的衣服剥光
，and take off all his clothes，
然后用很多的啊东西啊凶器来打他。
They use all kinds of things to fight him。
然后把他打晕了以后，把他扔到一个屋子里面去。
And when he was almost died, they took him to a room。
啊，醒过来的时候，然后把他又放在外面，冬天夜里面在里面冻他。
And when he wake up, they took him outside and put him outside in the when there was snow and they let him sleep there during the night.
但是被他们打得死去活来。
At that time, my grandpa almost died because of all this fight and all this.
当我母亲去看我的爷爷的时候。
And when my mother went to see my grandpa.
他总是很喜乐地安慰我的母亲。
And my grandpa always comfort my mom in great joys.
他说孩子没事的。
He said it's okay, baby.
他说神特别与我同在。
God's presence is with me.
他说放心。
Don't worry.
一定没有事的。
There will be nothing.
神会保守我。
God will protect me.
所以他们在那个时间不断的来，啊，就是不断的来批斗他。
So at that time, they always like took him to in the public and fight him, and let him repudiate the name of Jesus.
也出来的时候用那个白纸糊一个高帽子。
And they use the big white papers to build a really high hat and put it on his head.
然后戴在他的头上。
Yeah, and put it on his head.
然后用那个面糊糊很热的面糊倒在他的身上。
And they made a really hot, like they use flour to make a really hot liquid and pour it up on him.
然后把一些控告他的一些话语大字报贴在他的身上。
And they write a lot of banned words on the paper and stick it onto his body.
然后用那个芦苇做的那个小白旗。
And they use a kind of plate to make a little flag.
然后从他的背部，从那个镜像这里插进去。
And they put the flag on the back of my grandfather.
然后把他们在审判的时候把他打得晕了。
And during the time when he was fight in the public, he there were a lot of times he almost died.
然后他们就两个人拖着他在地上走。
And there were two persons pull him on the street.
然后他的鞋子被脱掉了。
And took off his shoes.
他的脚被磨破。
So his feet was hurt by the ground.
在地上出现两条血印。
There was two lines of blood on the street.
所以后来我听到我的家人在做我爷爷的见证。
And later, I hear the testimonies of my grandfather.
后来我的爷爷在不长的时间就被主接走了。
After a short time, my grandfather was taken to the heaven by Jesus.
当我爷爷被主接走的时候，我的母亲亲眼看到天使来迎接他。
And when my grandfather died, my mother saw the angels in heaven, took him.
所以我的爷爷为主做了很美好的见证。
So there was really a great testimony in my grandpa's life.
从我们今天我们后代的祝福。
And he's also a blessing for us.
我们领受了一人后裔的祝福。
So we received the blessings and the sons and daughters of righteousness.
当我父亲那一代，他们的信仰也是受到很大的逼迫。
There was also persecution during my father's time.
那时候因着我的祖父被主接走。
Because my grandfather was martyred.
家庭仍然受到一些的逼迫。
There was still persecution in our family.
然后我的父亲的房屋完全被没收。
And during that time, my father's house was taken by the government.
家产被他们抢夺。
And all the properties, and they took all the properties.
我们的家五次被抄家。
There were five times that our house was closed by the government.
所以在那时候，我的父亲就是仰望神而生活。
At that time, my father. Because the government took all the properties, my father always lived upon God.
我们的家人在文化大革命期间
during the time of revolution movement in China,
常常受凌辱
we always receive
被虐待苦待
Sorry. We always, yeah, insults.
我从小也没有自己的家。
And I don't have my own house when I was little.
没有自己的房子。
And I don't have my own room.
但神在那个时代当中，真的是我们经历了他特别的同在。
But we really experienced the presence of God during that time.
真的，在我小的时候，我们在我们那个村庄里面，小孩子随便可以欺负我们。
When I was little, all the children in our local place can insult us.
所以我的父母在村子里面也是非常的备受歧视。
And they also insult my parents. The adults also insult my parents during that time.
我小的时候也常常看到我的父母被他们所虐待。
At that time, I sometimes saw that they insult my parents.
但是后来那虐待我们、逼迫我们的人，神都让他们都让他们得到了应有的惩罚。
So but later the person who insult my parents, they receive what they did.
我们看到神借着那样的逼迫
，But through the persecution，
塑造了我们家人的生命。
Our lives was grown in Jesus Christ。
而我们就是一个坚持到底的信仰。
And our belief will never give up. It will always keep
永远都不会放弃。
And we will never give up。
虽然在文化大革命期间
，Although during the time of Chinese Revolution，
逼迫非常的严厉。
There was really a great persecution.
但是我们的家人仍然偷偷的来聚会。
But our family will always gather together secretly.
一直没有停止接待。
and we never stop accepting missionaries from the Western countries.
我们这个家庭是100多年的时间一直是一个接待服事的一个家庭。
So our family was always receiving missionaries during the 100 years.
在我小的时候，有一次给我很大的印象。
There was I remember when I was very little.
有一次我们接待一个黄牧师。
At that time we were welcoming Pastor Huang.
那个时候聚会的时候要把窗子全部都关上。
During that time during our meeting we should close all our windows.
就点一个小的煤油灯。
And we use a really little like candle, something like that.
当时有20多个信徒我们聚在一起聚会。
There were more than 20 people during in our meeting.
当神的仆人刚刚从怀里把圣经拿出来。
When the pastor just pull out the Bible.
就有两支枪就顶在他的头上。
And there were two people came and put their gun on his head.
然后就看到神的仆人被他们带走。
And then the pastor was taken by them.
然后这些信徒也被他们带走。
And all the Christians gathered there were taken.
因为我那个时候很小，他们也没有把我带走。
Because I was too little at that time, they didn't take me.
把他们带去以后，整夜来审判他们。
And when they took them, they put them, they asking questions all overnight.
他们想把他的圣经给烧掉。
They tried to put his Bible on fire.
但是他们怎么样也点不着。
But they never light up their yeah right their lighter.
最后他们把那个油倒在圣经上。
And then they pour their oil on the Bible.
点了以后马上又灭了。
And when they put on fire, it didn't burn. It just how to say it just it just didn't burn.
然后他们就生气地把圣经扔到一边。
And they were so angry, and they threw the Bible on the ground.
因为在那些年间，我们真的看到了神美好的见证。
We really had a lot. There were a lot of miracles at that time.
神的仆人然后被鞭打。
And the pastor, the servant of God was fined by the government.
然后就警告他们一句话。
And they were warned that.
如果你再进到我们这个村庄。
If you come to our village one more time.
我们就用枪把你打死。
We will kill you by gun.
但是以后还是凭着信心来。
But the pastor still come to our village by faith.
一直没有停止。
And he never stopped.
真的向神感恩。
We're really thankful.
他当神的呼召临到我的时候。
When the calling from God on me.
因为我从小就是一个被神所呼召的人。
I was called by God when I was very little.
在我9岁的时候。
When I was 9 years old.
神在夜间就向我母亲说话。
God speak to my mother during the time during the night.
神就告诉我的母亲说。
God told my mother that.
你要把你一个儿子奉献给我。
You will offer me one of your sons.
因为我母亲有两个儿子。
Because my mother has 2 sons.
我有一个弟弟。
I have a younger brother.
我的母亲就问神说。
And my mother asked God.
你要哪一个？
Which one do you want?
神说。
And God said.
就提着我的名字说我要回军。
I want you.
因为我在家里我是长子。
I want the elder one.
神是喜欢长子的。
And because I am the older, God said I want the elder one. And because I'm the older one, God always want the older one.
但是当时我的母亲不舍得把我奉献给神。
But at that time, my mother didn't want to give me to God.
因为我的弟弟头脑稍微有点的弱智。
Because my younger brother has a lot of has a little mental problem.
不是非常的聪明。
And he's not very clever.
我的母亲一直就是想让我来承担这个家庭。
And my mom wants me to work and support our whole family.
当时要呼召我的时候。
And when God called me.
我的母亲就觉得以后这个家庭生活很困难。
And my mother said that if I offer my elder son, then our family won't have enough money to be supported.
我的母亲第二天早上就对我哭着对我说。
And then the second day, my mother came to me and cried.
她昨天晚上神要我要给她一个孩子。
And she said that last night, God speak to me that he want one of my sons.
我也很高兴地问我的母亲说
，And I was so happy, and I asked my mom.
啊，谁要谁啊？神要谁
？Which one God would like?
我的母亲说，神提着名字要你。
God said he wants you.
啊，因为当时我小，我不是很清楚。
At that time, I was very little, so I do not really understand.
但是我记得很清楚，我的母亲是流着泪告诉我。
But I'm very clear that my mother told us with her tears.
当时可能我不理解我的母亲。
And at that time, I cannot understand why he cries.
以后我会理解她内心当中有她的伤痛。
But later, I realized that she has his own concerns in her heart.
从那个时候，神就把一个渴慕的心放在我的里面。
At that time, God has prepared a great heart in my.
我从小就很渴慕要做一名，要做一个牧师。
I really want to be a pastor when I was little.
因为我每一次看到那个牧师在宣读圣经的时候，然后被抓的时候，我觉得他们非常的尊贵。
When I was little, I saw the pastor. They were share the gospel with the Bible, and they were taking. So during that time, I had the feeling that the pastors are really precious. They are really honored.
我相信那是神特别的恩典。
And that is because God's special grace on.
每一次遇到那样的逼迫，我没有惧怕。
So, although there was a lot of persecution, I'm not afraid.
但是我却看到神的仆人是那样的尊贵。
And I saw the pastors were so honored.
所以我也愿意立志在这一生当中，愿意来服侍神。
So I really want to serve God all my life.
因着服侍也会带来一些的逼迫。
When I began to serve, there was also a persecution.
其实我们教会再一次复兴临到是从1992年。
Since 1992, there was a great revival came to our local area again.
在92年之前，我是一直在社会上工作。
Before that, I was working outside the church.
我从83年学习开车。
I learned how to drive during 1983.
在生命当中经历了神很多的见证。
During that time, I also experienced a lot of miracles.
多次在危险当中神搭救我。
During a lot of time when I drive, there was dangerous.Time, but God has protect me.
在那个时候，我已经忘记了神在我生命当中的呼召。
At that time, I cannot remember my call from God.
我只感受到神特别的爱我。
I just know that God loves me so much.
我只向神祷告说，给我很多的财富。
And I pray God that give me more money.
我也觉得这就是神的祝福。
And I regard that as a blessing.
但是没有感受到生命的重要。
But at that time I didn't realize the importance of my spiritual life.
后来在一次车祸当中。
And then later there was a great car accident.
几乎要完全的丧命。
I almost died during the accident.
但是神却特别保守我。
But God has protected me.
我又在神面前向神祷告说。
I prayed to God that.
神啊，你为什么救我
？God, why you save me?
神就在我的生命当中。让我非常的清楚知道。
And God told me very clearly that
神要使用我。
God will use me.
所以我常常在神面前宣告。
So I always declare before God.
有使命的人死不了。
A person who has God called in his life will never die.
Amen. 所以我从93年开始全职服侍神。
So I began to work as a full-time minister in church since 1993.
从那时候开始接待一些国外的传道人。
At that time, our church started to have a lot of missionaries from overseas.
在本地的教会开始有门徒培训。
And we began to have disciple training during that time.
然后领着一帮年轻人传福音。
And we lead a lot of young people to share the gospel.
然后会跟大家在一起啊，在村子里面敲锣打鼓，到处传福音。
And in our local area, we use drums to make sound and then share the gospel to go through the whole village and share the gospel.
然后我们把很多福音单张张贴在那个墙上。
We always made some write the gospel on the paper and stick them everywhere in our village.
后来他们就被公安发现了。
And then the policeman saw them.
然后他们就开始来捉拿我们。
And they began to find us.
在我们传福音的时候。
And during the time when we shared the gospel.
好像把我们的一些同工抓去。
The policeman took a lot of our co-workers.
然后把他们放在监狱里面。
And they were put into prison.
当时我也是被他们抓在监狱当中。
I was one of them.
我也是在96年前后多次被抓的人。
I was put into prison a lot of times during the year of 1996.
每次被他们抓去的时候。
Every time when I was put into prison.
他们总是会警告我。
They always warn me.
他以后绝对不允许再这样做。
So they always warn me that you will never do this later.
那我就跟他们讲。
And I told them.
他说这是我的信仰。
This is my belief.
我就对他们说。
And I said to them.
你们所做的你们就做吧。
You do what you want.
因为那是你们的工作。
Because that is your work.
我永远不会恨你们。
I never hate you.
所以后来我们的关系很好。
And then later we have really good relationship among us.
多次捉拿我的人都愿意要接受福音。
And the person who put me into prison later they want to receive the gospel.
有一次他们早上一早就到我家里去。
There was one time that in the early morning they came to my house.
当时我们还没有起床。
At that time we haven't got up.
他们就翻墙到我家里。
And they just jump out of our wall and into our house.
然后他们就给我戴上手铐，就把我带走了。
And they put the handles on my head and then took me.
那次因为我是一方面传福音，另一方面就是接待国外的宣教士。
I was put into prison again because I shared the gospel and our church welcomed the missionaries and pastors from overseas.
在那些年间，他们把国外的宣教士当作是敌人。
At that time, the Chinese government regard the missionaries and pastors overseas as enemies.
常常提醒我说，你不允许跟这些特务能够来往。
The enemies always warn me that you shouldn't have relationship with those they regard as spies.
我就跟他们讲，这些不是特务，这是我们的家人。
I told them they are not spies, they are our family.
我说全世界信耶稣的人都是一家人。
And we are all families, as Christians among all the world.
啊，因为他们不理解。
And because they didn't understand.
所以有一次他们就把我抓在监狱里面。
So they put me into prison.
然后就让我交代这些接待的人。
And one time they asked me to see something about what whom I receive, I accept the Western missionaries.
让我报告他们的名字，他们的国家， 他们的家庭情况。
And they like me to report their names and their which country they're from and anything about them.
然后我就不告诉他们。
But I didn't tell them.
所以他们就连续五天五夜来审讯。
So they asked me questions and did not allow me to sleep more than five days and five nights.
但是他们安排三个工作组。
And they have three teams.
昼夜的来审问。
Three teams then took turns to ask me questions.
当第五天的时候。
And at the end of the fifth day,
我自己已经控制不了。
I cannot control myself.
他们所问的问题在我的头脑里面不断的浮现。
I was so tired and I cannot control myself. And when they ask, there were a lot of questions in my head.
在那时候就是随时会把这一切完全告诉给他们。
So at that time, I was, my head was lose control. So, I got any chance to, I cannot control myself. So, I was easily to tell them all the informations about the Western missionaries.
我就向神祷告。
But I pray to God that.
我说神啊。
Lord,
我已经控制不了了。
I cannot control myself.
我要把我的思想意念完全交给你。
But I will put my mind into your hand.
一定要保守我。
Please protect me.
不要出卖任何一位神的仆人。
And control me that I will not tell anything about the missionaries, about your servant to the government.
也不要出卖我的同工。
And I will not betray my co-workers.
所以神很奇妙的。
So God is so amazing.
让他们的审讯就停止了。
And God stopped their questions. They're ending their conversations.
然后他们就把我放在监狱里面。
And they put me into prison.
当我刚刚进入里面的时候。
When I was first into the prison, first time when I into the prison.
他们就觉得我不会再出来。
And they think I will never be out of the prison.
一定会判我死刑的。
And they will put me into death.
所以他们就把我放在监狱里面的第一号。
So they put me into number one prison.
里面所有的人基本上都是判死刑的。
In that prison, all of the prisoners, all of the people in that prison, will have death sentence.
但神很奇妙的恩典。
But God is, God has His great grace.
在里面一直在保守我。
And God always protects me during that time.
当我们进到里面去的时候。
When I was put into prison.
那些罪犯也是彼此的要残害。
The people in the prison always fight each other.
我一进去，他们就问你是为什么进来的。
And when I walk into it, they ask me why do you came here?
然后他们就说，我就告诉他们说我是因为相信耶稣。
And I told them because I believe in Jesus Christ.
好，信耶稣为什么到监狱里面来
？And they ask why they put you into prison as a Christian.
我心里讲我是为你们来的。
And I thought in my heart that I was here for you guys.
那时候我没有直接这样讲。
But I didn't speak it out. I just had that thought in my heart.
我说我也不知道。
And I answered them, I don't know.
然后他就告诉他的所有在里面的那些罪犯说。所有在里面已经判刑的人。
And they said to each other in the prison.
然后按照我们的规矩来给他来就是来折磨他。
Let's use our rules to do the things on the person who came.
我看到大家要动手。
And I saw that the person began to prepare.
我就主动的对他们讲，我说你们有什么规矩
？And I just stand out and say, what kind of rules do you have?
他说我们首先要洗那个凉水澡。
And they said the first thing you should do is you should take a really cold shower.
因为那是冬天。
Because that, during that time it was winter.
一般不会主动的要倒那个凉水，他们就用他们的盆子一盆一盆浇在你的身上。
So we don't want to take any cold shower, and they force us, they pour pour a lot of cold waters on the person.
当他们告诉我的时候，我就跟他们讲，我说天气太冷，我说不用你们动手，我自己来。
At that time, I told them that you guys do not need to do this for me. I can do it by myself.
然后我就自己把外面衣服都完全脱了。
And I took all of my clothes.
我就用那个盆接一盆水倒在头上。
And I use a pan to hold the cold water and put it all over me.
然后我又接一盆又倒在头上。
And there I put another hot water, cold water upon me.
当我浇了三盆的时候。
And after three times down.
他们里边那个带头的就说啊，好了好了好了，不用再浇了。
The leaders in the prison said that it's okay, it's okay.
我也到里面把那个身上擦干了以后，穿上衣服。
And then I went into my place and dried myself and put on my clothes.
啊，我在那么寒冷的天气，一点没有感觉冷。
And I didn't feel cold anymore during that time, although it is winter.
我感而发觉身上出了一身汗。
I just felt I just feel sweat at that time.
我在没有我在这之前，我有一个鼻炎的病。
Before this, I have some problem with my nose.
如果用凉水洗脸的话，鼻子也不通气的。
When I use cold water to wash my face, my nose will not feel comfortable.
但是就是因着这样的一个洗礼，我的鼻炎完全得到医治了。
And because I do this, my nose was completely healed by God.
Amen. 是我相信神是把我带到这样的一个环境来塑造我的生命。
So I believe that God want to let me learn something from this environment, from this situation.
在里面，食物非常的短缺。
When I was in prison, we don't have enough food to eat.
有时候感觉到非常的饥饿。
There were a lot of times that I feel so hungry.
然后白天晚上有那个吼叫的声音。
And during the night, there was something, someone shouting outside.
在这里面会感觉到很大的惧怕。
So I feel so afraid when I was in prison.
常常在里面很多的那个罪犯晚上会吓醒。
A lot of criminals in the prison, they were frightened a lot of time during the night.
但我在里面却是享受到神极大的平安。
But I really experienced the great peace in my heart.
在我缺乏的时候，神特别来帮助我。
And when God really helped me when I was in short of something.
当我在非常饥饿的时候。
When I was very hungry.
神也为我所预备了饮食。
God prepared food for me.
那是我在一生当中都不会忘记的。
I will never forget that thing in my life.
有一天。
There was one day.
当我听到那个监门响的时候。
When I heard the door of the prison were opened.
啊，我认为那是他们送饭的来了。
I thought the person who bring us the food.
因为在监狱里面，杜甫非常的饥饿。
Because when we were in prison, we always feel hungry.
随时就盼望着食物。
So we always hope that someone would bring us food.
所以一听到门响。
So when I heard the sound,
就会认为就是来送食物的。
I thought there was a person who bring us food.
所以当他们一开那个门的时候。
So when they opened the door,
就喊叫我的名字。
They called my name.
当一喊名字，我们知道就有麻烦来了。
And when they called my name, I know that I will be in trouble.
我也觉得这顿饭是肯定吃不上的。
And I know that maybe they will not give me food at this time.
然后他们给我戴上手铐。
And they put the handcuffs on my
然后把我带到一个很偏僻的一个地方。
On my head and took me into a place.
当我一进去的时候。
When I went there.
发现一个小的桌子，一满桌子的菜。
I found there was a table full of food.
然后他们就让我坐下来。
And they let me to sit down.
他说这是给你预备的，你吃吧。
And they said those are all prepared for you. Just eat.
虽然我在啊，在这之前我是为这个饭食已经向神献祷告的。
Before this, I prayed God for food.
当时并不知道神预备的这么丰盛。
But I didn't know that God prepared so abundantly.
大家看到这一桌子的菜的时候，我反而有点担心。
When I saw this, the whole table of food, I was a little bit anxious.
因为在过去有这样的一个传统，就是说一个人当送他要枪毙要上路的时候，就让他就要让他吃一顿饭的。
There was a tradition in our country that before someone was killed, before someone is going to be killed, they will prepare an abundant dinner for him.
我就坐在那里继续默默地来祷告。
So I sit down and prayed in my heart.
然后那个人就告诉我，你快吃吧。
And the person told me that just eat.
你赶紧吃完了，赶紧回去。
And just eat quickly and then go back to your place.
我祷告了以后，心里面非常平安。
After I prayed, I feel peace in my heart.
我就在吃那些食物。
So I began to eat.
但是我吃的时候
，during the time when I was eating,
我的眼泪就流下来。
And I had tears.
诗篇二十三篇就出现在我的心里面。
And the scripture in Psalms chapter 23 occurred in my head.
大卫所写的诗。
And then is the psalm that King David has wrote.
说在我敌人面前，你为我摆设宴席。
He said that before my enemies, you prepared the table.
所以在那时候，我经历的神特别大的同在。
So I experienced God great peace and presence at that time.
神体贴我们的软弱。
God knows our weakness.
现在有丰富的供应。
But God will provide us abundantly.
我真的向神献上极大的感恩。
I was so thankful to God.
所以逼迫对我们来说是祝福。
So to me,Persecution is a blessing from God.
患难是我们的恩典。
And the sufferings is God's grace for us.
这是神在我们生命当中所给我们预备。
This is God has prepared for us.
也是我们生命所需要的。
And this is also that we should learn from God.
也在罗马书第五章三到五节。
In Romans chapter 5:3-5 says.
圣经说不但如此，就是在患难中也是欢欢喜喜的。因为知道患难生忍耐，忍耐生老练，老练生盼望，盼望不至于羞耻。因为所赐给我们的圣灵将神的爱浇灌在我们心里。
It says, not only so, but we also rejoice in our sufferings, because we know that suffering produces perseverance, character,And character hope, and hope does not disappoint us, because God has poured out His love into our hearts by the Holy Spirit, whom He has given us.
Amen.
Amen.
所以我在我的生命当中经历了神很大的恩典。
So I experienced God's great grace in my life.
看到神在我们整个家庭当中。他奇妙的作为。
And I saw all God's great works in my family.
虽然经过逼迫。
Although there were persecution.
但我没有被逼迫所吓倒。
But we were not afraid of the persecution.
在逼迫当中。
During the time of persecution.
神塑造了我们家里的生命。
God has grown our spiritual family in our family.
让我们更多的经历神的同在。
So that we can experience more presence from God.
因为我们的生命需要这样的环境。
Because our spiritual life needs this kind of situation.
因为我们在患难当中，我们就知道呼求神。
Because in our sufferings, in our persecution, we want to search for God.
往在平安稳妥的时候，就忘记求告神。
When we were in comfortable place, a lot of times we forgot to search for God.
神也是借这样的环境。 来塑造了整个中国的教会。
So God used this environment to model His church in China.
在中国这片土地上。
In the land of China.
神借着逼迫。
God used persecution.
塑造了很多健康的生命。
Mold a lot of healthy lives.
让他们为着主将自己的生命完全的摆上。
So that they want to give their life to God.
为主献上了他们的一生。
And they want to use their whole life to serve for God.
我就要借着我们家庭这样的见证，来述说神的恩典。
So I'm here to share God's great testimonies in our family to tell the great works of God.
谢谢中国的教会。
So the Chinese churches.
也离不开美国教会对我们的祝福。
The Chinese churches, the Chinese churches need the blessings of the Western churches.
过去美国的教会很多宣教士在中国也是为我们做了做了美好的见证。
There were a lot of testimonies that the Western missionaries bring to our country.
是他们将他们的生命都献给中国。
And a lot of Western missionaries they gave their life to China.
在中国为神殉道。
And they were martyred in China.
且他们的血成为中国教会的祝福。
And their blood is a blessing to China.
说我们看到逼迫不会使教会停止。
So the growth of church will not stop by the persecution.
逼迫也不会使我们的生命萎缩。
Our spiritual life will not stop by persecution.
反而使教会更加的复兴。
But the persecution let our spiritual life grows fastly.
今天中国的教会。
Today, the Chinese churches is entered into another revival.
我们看到在中国各地
And we see that there were in the line of China.
教会都在复兴
There were a lot of churches were reviving.
并且进入宣教
And they want to be missionaries.
我们相信这是神极大的恩典。
And I know that this is a great grace from God.
我相信也是美国的教会为中国教会祷告所带来的一个果效。
I think this is also a result that that a lot of Western churches were praying for China.
今天我能够在这里为主做见证。
And today I can be here to tell the great testimonies.
是见证神的作为。
To speak the great work of God.
神对中国教会的祝福。
And the blessings God has put into Chinese churches.
也离不开美国教会给我们的祷告。
And we really need the prayers from Western churches.
所以今天为了能够在这里有这样的机会为主做见证。
So this time, this time I can have this experience to be here.
也表示对美国教会特别的感谢。
I was so thankful.
我也相信在这幕后的时代。
And I believe that in this generation.
美国的教会、中国的教会、世界各个国家的教会，我们要一同起来。
And all the churches from all around the world will bond together and wake up.
完成神所给我们的使命。
So that we can work together and fulfill the work of God.
迎接耶稣基督二次的再来。
And we will welcome in the second coming of Jesus Christ.
愿神祝福大家。
And may God bless all of you. Thank you.
Praise you, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Father.Hallelujah. We're so thankful to you, Lord, for those that are willing to give their life for the gospel of Jesus Christ and to stand in persecution and not be pushed back by the threats of authorities or by the enemy. We thank you, Jesus, for those that are willing to stand up for you, no matter what it costs them. That your name may be declared throughout the earth. That is what the gospel is about. Jesus came that we might have life and that we might live out his life and show the light of the gospel of Jesus Christ everywhere we go and everything that we do. And we thank you, Father God, that you touch every person in this place, Lord. Lord, in Jesus' name, the anointing, the anointing, the anointing, the anointing, the anointing, Father God. The anointing that breaks every yoke. The anointing, Father, that empowers every one of us to stand up and be the light of the gospel of Jesus Christ and declare your word. Father, every hindrance and every mind-blinding spirit broken, Father, and awakening in every life, may every person in this place come to know your great love wherewith you loved us. Father, your love, Lord Jesus, because when we're captivated by the love, Lord Jesus, we can't do anything else but to follow you. We can't do anything else but be the light of the gospel of Jesus Christ. We thank you, Father God, for your anointing in this place. Jesus, Jesus, show forth your glory right now. Show forth your glory, Father. I thank you, Father, for change right now. Father, I thank you that you're changing people as they sit in their seats right now. You're bringing the change. Father, those that haven't fully committed their life to the Lord Jesus Christ, but they're here. Father, we're so thankful for the people that are here to hear the gospel. Lord Jesus, we just thank you, Father, that you bring the change right now. Just right as you're in your seat right now, just let God touch you. Let him touch you by his Spirit. Let him touch you right now. And say, here I am, Lord. Here I am, Lord Jesus. I don't want my life anymore. I want the life of Jesus Christ. Lord, I give myself to you. Lord, no longer to live for myself, but to live my life for the gospel of Jesus Christ. I tell you, if you mean this with all of your heart, the change will come. Out of that fellowship and out of that relationship, you will see yourself be a person that you never knew, because God will take a hold of an offering that is laid upon his altar, an offering of sacrifice that is willing to say, here I am, take all of me. I pour out my life on you, Jesus. Father sees that, and it's not about what other people do or about what you go through or you don't go through. It's about a relationship that you have with your Heavenly Father. It's about that you have met your Savior, you have met your Lord, and he is your all in all. Here on earth, for us to live now this glorious gospel of Jesus Christ, so many people come to God, come to Jesus for something in eternity. They want to come to Jesus so they don't have to die and go to hell. But I tell you what, it's so much more than that. It's so that you can be co-laborers with Jesus Christ right here on earth, so you can have a fellowship and know him, so he can fill you with joy unspeakable and full of glory, so the peace that passes all understanding will rule and live in your heart right now. Right now, so you can be a light of the gospel of Jesus Christ, the light of the world living on the inside of you, so all men might see and know, but you got to have it here. It has to be here for you first. Father doesn't want you to come to a religion. He doesn't want you to come to be a part of a group or a club or, you know, to be in a place where you might feel accepted and people might love on you a little bit. He wants you to come to him and know eternal love that never ends, to have a relationship with him. Jesus died that you might have life right now and that you might live out his life so the world might see Jesus in you. Every person in this place God so deeply cares about. I know there's people in this place that you want God, but you haven't made a full decision to give it all to him, because there's some things in this life that could be holding you back. There's some things that are pulling on you, but Father is saying, you're here. This is your time. He brought you here. He specifically set you in this place today so you could come to him and say, here I am, Lord. I don't care what it costs me. I don't care what it costs me in this life, in this world. I need you, Jesus. I want the peace that passes all understanding to rule in my life and the life of those that are around me. I want to know you and behold you like I've never known you or I ever thought of knowing you. See, people have been told about a Jesus that isn't the gospel of Jesus Christ. It's another gospel. There's not another gospel, I'm going to tell you. But it's another gospel because it's not his gospel. His gospel takes all of you and changes you and forms you into him. Where you don't look like you anymore. You don't look like the people that are walking on the street that have never met him. But you look different. You walk different. You talk different. You act different. You live in joy unspeakable and full of glory because he's your all in all. Because you have met the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. That's the gospel that Jesus wants you to come to. That in persecution, that in trial, that in trouble, you are not moved. You are not moved by what goes on around you because you're in him and he's in you. And nothing can change that. Persecution can't change it. Other people's thoughts can't change it. What people have done to hurt you or affect you can't change it because you're in him and your all sufficiency is in him and your identity is in him and your hope is in him and your life is in him and him alone. So this life doesn't move you. This is the gospel that Jesus wants you to come to. Not a made up gospel in anyone's head, but the gospel of life eternal. If there's anyone in this place that wants prayer for any reason, if you're sick in your body, if you've got trouble in finances, if you don't know him like I'm talking about, we're just going to mix it all together. We want you to come to Jesus. We want you to come to the author and the finisher of your faith, the one that you're to look to in every trial, in every circumstance, the one that's in you, living alive in you, that has the peace that passes all understanding, ruling in you because you cast all of your cares upon him. For you know he cares for you. That's relationship. That's relationship. That's not coming to Father and saying, you're not enough, so I have to go and take of this. You're not enough because I have to go, so I have to go over here and fix it. See, Cain, he thought Jesus isn't enough. It wasn't enough. He had to do it his way. It's always man's way that gets in the way of God's way. But when you know that he's enough, he's enough. He's all sufficiency. He will supply all your needs. You don't have to, by your own arm and your own strength, go and bring in the finances to pay your rent and your light bill and your car expenses or whatever. You don't have to do it by your ability. You can go to the job that Father supplied. And it will be joy unspeakable. It'll be your mission field. It may be work for a day or 2 months or whatever. It's the supply that you need. Or if you're just so wrapped up in seeking first the kingdom of God and his righteousness that you're so in the ministry day in, day out, he'll bring that money in if he has to rain it down out of heaven. Just knowing that he's enough, that he's your supply, that he's all you need. He's enough. He's more than enough. So if anyone wants prayer for any reason, we'd like you to come now and we'd like to pray for you. And everyone that doesn't need prayer, then we'd like you to pray in your seats for the people that come up and need prayer. The body together functioning. The body together in unity, seeing God move by his Spirit. Hallelujah. So come now, come quickly. Don't wait if you need prayer. Don't come up 5 minutes from now. Come up now if you want prayer. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus is here to meet your need. It's not us that's here to meet your need. You are coming before the Father and presenting what you have need of. You are coming and saying, okay, Father, you are enough and I need more than enough and I'm receiving it right now. So you right now take your need, you take your need to him right now and you hold it before the Father. You're standing before him. This is in standing before him and receiving from him the more than enough for whatever you have need of. God has more than enough for you, Jenny. God has more than enough for you. Every person up here, he has more than enough for you to walk through the day day after day, the walk through this life in joy unspeakable and full of glory with the peace that passes all understanding, being a light of the gospel of Jesus Christ no matter what's going on. And when you take a hold of that, things around you will change. Things around you will change. So right now, as you're bringing it before Him, we just thank You, Father God, that every person standing here will receive from You right now, because it is Your pleasure to give them the kingdom. So this is just small things that they're receiving right now. But Lord, I just ask You to open every heart in this place to receive all sufficiency from You right now. To receive all sufficiency from You right now in Jesus' name. The glory of God comes on you right now. Just receive. The glory of God comes on you right now. Just receive it, sister. Receive. Receive. He's enough. He's enough for everything that you're going through. He's enough. He's more than enough. He's more than enough. He's more than enough. Just take it. Just take it. Just like He was handing it to you right now. You literally feel like He's handing it to you right now. What would you do? Would you reach out and grab it? Would you say, yeah, it's mine? Or you would say, I can't have that. Lord, I haven't done enough. It's not about what we do. It's about what He's done. Our position is to receive what He paid for. He did it. And He says, you receive. Just receive what I've done. It's not about what you do, because I tell you, you can't ever do enough to come to Him and be worthy. You can't ever do enough. He just says, receive what I've done. Isn't that amazing? He loves us so much. He paid it all. Thank You, Jesus. I just thank You, Father, for the anointing right now. I thank You, Father, for the anointing right now in Jesus' name. Thank You, Father. Thank You, Father, for the glory of heaven. I thank You, Father, right now that in this place, You're moving on people's hearts to step out in ministry. Lord Jesus, those that have been a little bit waiting around but know the call is on them. They've been waiting around. Father, they've been waiting around to step out. Father, whether it's here or wherever it's at, they've been waiting around. Father, I just thank You right now in Jesus' name. Father, that they just take a hold of it and they receive right now. They take a hold, Father, and they just say, Father, I'm not sitting on the sidelines anymore, but I'm going to get up and I'm going to run with this gospel. I'm going to run with what You put on the inside of me. I'm going to let it explode right here where I'm at. Because if you can't let the gospel explode right where you're at, it's not going to do you a lot of good to buy a ticket and go somewhere else. Because you're going to curl up in a ball and hide in fear in the corner, especially if persecution comes along. Because one of the biggest things that hold people back right here in the United States is fear. I tell you what, you got all of heaven on your side. You don't have to be afraid of nothing. God has put you where you're at for a reason right now. You are not here just because something happened and you ended up here. Or you were born here. You're here because God has a purpose for you in San Diego, California, to show forth His glory. Every person in this place, He wants you to show forth His glory. He is looking for those that will just say, yes, I receive and I'll be the light. Hallelujah. The whole place, just reach out. Just reach out right now and receive it. Just reach out right now and receive it. Father, the hindrances that have come against Your people, Father, we bind them, we break them in Jesus' name. We thank You, Father, that You are raising up those that will even go and be martyred for the gospel of Jesus Christ. They will hold nothing back, but they will give it all to You, to live it out for You, Father. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank You, Jesus, for Your anointing. For Your anointing. For Your anointing right now. Just receive, 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 receive. Receive, receive in Jesus' name. Receive by the Spirit. Receive right now. Receive, receive right now in Jesus' name. Receive, Father, right now in Jesus' name. Receive, receive in Jesus' name. Receive in Jesus' name. He's more than enough. He's more than enough. The things we walk through, they're not bigger than He is. They're not bigger. You're bigger because He's in you. They're not bigger. He's bigger. He's in you. Who's in you? It's more than enough. He's more than enough. You have all the supply you need.
You have all the supply you need that you can walk it out in victory. No more letting the enemy push you back. You are the overcomer in Christ Jesus. Live like overcomers in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, you're an overcomer. You're an overcomer. Just receive it right now. Overcomer in Jesus Christ. It's all Him. It's not you. It's all Him. It's not you. We thank you, Father, for the glory right here. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for the anointing of the Holy Ghost. We thank you, Jesus, for the total surrender, Father, to whatever you ask in Jesus' name. Yetolame Shela Rende Lomoso Lemoshete. In Jesus' name. Every hindrance of the enemy broken. Every lie. In Jesus' name. Unspeakable and full of glory. It is joy, 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 joy unspeakable. There's nothing greater than living with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And in Him, and He likens the church. He likens you. Being in Him, the unity of the husband and the wife, that unity becoming one flesh. We're bone of His bone and flesh of His flesh. We're bone of His bone and flesh of His flesh. He's Papa. It is Papa's good pleasure to give you all you have need of. It is Papa's good pleasure to make you the light of the gospel of Jesus Christ. It is Papa's good pleasure for you to open your mouth and let Him speak through you. Thank you, Jesus. Selah, in Jesus' name. Selena Mokoche. Receive, receive right now. In Jesus, the glory of heaven. The glory of heaven. Please, Father, right away. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for Joseph. Thank you, Father, for Joseph keeping the kids in the house of God. Father, we thank you for your anointing upon him. Father, in the name of Jesus. Just the increase, the increase, the increase, the increase, the increase. Father, come. Father, cause yourself to be branded by your Spirit. Father, brand him. Brand him. Father, brand him. Brand him. We praise you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for the anointing right here. We thank you, Father, for worship. Father said, suffer the little children to come unto me, for such is the kingdom. Amen. Well, saints of God, come tonight pressing in expectation for God to do great things. Thank you, Jesus. And grab somebody and bring them with you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We praise you, Father. We praise you, Father. We thank you, Lord. If you can be dismissed, you can be dismissed. If you're praying, we don't want anyone to disturb those that are up here in the altar. But if you need to go, we understand. But go in the anointing and the power of the Holy Ghost. Go in what God's making has made you in Him. Go in His identity, not this earth's identity, not what man's tried to form and fashion you into, but what He's made you. Forget about what man says. Forget about what this earth has taught you. Forget about those things and look what He has taught you. Look who He has said you are. And just live out the glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Father. Hallelujah. If there's anybody else, I just feel one more time. I was dismissing, but if there's anybody else that needs prayer, we just want to pray with you. Just give it a couple more seconds here and then we'll move on. Thank you, Jesus, for the anointing. Thank you, Jesus, for the increase. Thank you, Jesus. In that secret place. In the secret place. In the secret place. It takes a secret place to move out. You can't move out without a secret place. You can't do anything without it. It's not your turn yet, but it's getting close. Just get a little bit more time. But it's not like fun. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Father, we just thank you for your presence. Sweet presence of the Holy Spirit in this place. That's because there's a bunch of Holy Ghost people in this place. We love every one of you. Be blessed. We'll see you tonight. So come rejoicing in the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Amen.